So welcome to Bhakti Sangha Japa Conference, welcoming everyone to the mid-morning Chaitanya Charitamrita session. Today's class will be given by His Grace Ram Giridhari Prabhu. Ram Giridhari Prabhu will be speaking on Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Leela chapter 22, and it is verse 140. So thank you so much, Prabhu, for joining and giving us your valuable association. You can now take over the call. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda. जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंदा जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंदा काम त्याजी कृष्ण बजे शास्त्र आज्ञमानी देवऋषि पित्र दिकेरा कबू न हेरिणी.
Translation: if a person gives up all material desires and completely engages in the transcendental loving service of Krishna as enjoined in the revealed scriptures, he is never indebted to the demigods, sages, or forefathers. Purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
After birth, every man is indebted in so many ways. He is indebted to the demigods for their supplying necessities like air, light and water. When one takes advantage of the Vedic literature, one becomes indebted to great sages like Vyasadeva, Narada, Devala and Asita. When one takes birth in a particular family, he becomes indebted to his forefathers. We are even indebted to common living entities like cows, from whom we take milk. Because we accept service from so many animals, we become indebted. However, if one is completely engaged in Lord's devotional service, he is absolved of all debts. This is confirmed in the following verse quoted from Srimad Bhagavatam. So, we are reading from Madhya Leela, the chapter title, The Process of Devotional Service. The context that we are in is when Mahaprabhu has finished this discussion to Sanatana Goswami about devotees, non-devotees, association. Then he spoke about devotional service. Then he talked about how the 64 angas of devotional service. And he is getting deeper and deeper. And he is now finished discussing about the five limbs of devotional service. The current situation, the current sloka is where he is explaining about some examples of how some people who followed this process of devotional service, how they were successful. So, the next verse, 141, is also talking about the same context, but Mahaprabhu is exclusively, you know, narrating the verse that Srila Prabhupada has given reference in the purport. In today's discussion, let's turn this
particular shloka and get some nectar out of it. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaurabhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So this indebtedness is a very powerful and important subject matter. Gratitude and humility are two qualities on which our devotional journey, the train that takes us back home, back to Godhead, runs. The rails which are gratitude and humility enables a sadhaka to not only move forward but also carry others forward with them. The point is, anyone who is learning about this indebtedness will naturally be humble. Anyone who is naturally humble will be naturally engaged in the service of the bona fide personalities because of whom we are humble and towards whom we are grateful. And that service definitely enables us to carry as many people as we could towards Krishna. So the indebtedness that is listed over here is something that is not so higher in comparison to the gratefulness that we need to show to the Acharyas and Vaishnavas and spiritual master. But at the same time, we are definitely indebted to various personalities because of whom our existence is in place. And these indebtedness, if we start settling or start repaying, can never be settled. It's an ongoing, ever-increasing debt, because every day for our survival we use them or we take their help. Even though they in turn take Krishna's order to do their service, it is a gentleman's quality to show his indebtedness. And since Vaishnavas are expected to be a gentleman, where we don't take help, rather we are available for all help. In the sense,
I do not utilize resources for my sake, rather I utilize all the resources for the sake of glorification of Krishna is a general mindset in which a Vaishnava stays. From that perspective, this shloka helps us how when we give up all material desires and engage ourselves in the transcendental loving service of Krishna, by just one activity, multiple things are taken care. As a part of today's reflection, we are going to learn some interesting concepts or thoughts which can help us to introspect, contemplate more on our spiritual journey. First of all, this material desires that we are struggling with, because of which the distance between us and the Supreme Lord is far away, has to be understood properly. So the first reflection, we are going to discuss about a theory called Are You Sure Theory. In our devotional life, we are always questioned by various agencies about are you sure? Let's rewind back to our pre-Krishna conscious days and let's go back in timeline that we were just met devotees or just came in contact with Srila Prabhupada's books or just got introduced to Krishna consciousness, and the moment before that, the moment before we came in contact with devotees, Krishna consciousness program, Krishna consciousness activities, books of Srila Prabhupada, devotees, our life's goal had been, like anybody else, self-centered. And the target, only target is, how can I exploit this world and enjoy to the maximum? Somehow by the mercy of Guru, Vaishnava and Agyata Sukriti, we come in contact with some components of Krishna consciousness and we show our initial Shraddha. When we show our initial Shraddha, we still have not relinquished our materialistic desires. So we will be questioned by our friends at that point in time, our colleagues, our neighbors, our family members, and all the more, our own mind and intelligence. Are you sure, my dear? You want to do this? And this are you sure question comes from multiple corners at one go, because there is a sudden change in our personality, in the sense of our activities, our preferences. May not be in the intensity wise, but at least in terms of activity wise, there is a change. And hence, all our so-called beloved, near and dear ones will ask us the question, are you sure? That's the first time our Shraddha will be challenged. Whatever little faith, adav Shraddha that we had, will be challenged at that point in time when somebody asks you,
Are you sure you want to go to ISKCON? Are you sure you want to go to the temple? Are you sure at this age you want to do this? And that time there is a big tussle between our mind and intelligence. As a part of the tussle, depends upon how strong our intelligence is. Our mind can be controlled, tamed, or we relinquish. It is like a small baby trying to walk after crawling. We try to get up, then we fall down. Get up, fall down. Get up, fall down. So technically we came to Krishna consciousness. Different people came to Krishna consciousness from different reasons. Artho, Jignyashu, Artharthi, Jnani. So everybody would have come from different corners, or we all would be trying to toiter, trying to wobble in our own capacity. And when somebody asks, are you sure? Depends upon the intensity that we possess. We either further stand up and walk past, or we sit down back. And from that point in time, depends upon how we facilitate and fan the Shraddha to make ourselves a serious practitioner. We are able to respond to those are you sure questions. Yes, I am sure I wanted to do this. Yes, I am sure I want to explore this. Yes, I am sure that I want to, you know, interact and see how, what it takes. Yes, I am sure that this is interesting, so let me see what I'm going to gain. Even though it is with doubts, that Shraddha is challenged and we win over that Shraddha. Then we keep practicing Krishna consciousness, and one fine day we develop a next level of Shraddha where we say that I want to surrender to a bona fide spiritual master. So previously Maya questioned you in the form of friends, neighbors, colleagues, relatives, family members, mind as well as intelligence. So Maya tested, material nature tested us if our Shraddha is firm. And now the second person who is going to test us and ask the same question, are you sure, will be our spiritual master. When we go and ask him, Gurudev, please give me initiation. Please accept me in your lotus feet. Please engage me in your service. Please consider me as your disciple. The spiritual master examines our Shraddha and asks the question, are you sure? It is said, it is a duty of the spiritual master to ask this question at the time of initiation, and according to Shastra, at the time of marriage, the priest need to ask the boy as well as the girl. So it is said that the spiritual master need to give a last chance for the disciple to reconsider, because when he accepts the spiritual master, it is the next level of commitment. And he can't go back, or technically he should not go back. Similarly, when a boy is making a commitment to marry a girl, the priest can still give him an option. Yes, so many arrangements have been done, people have been called, everything has been done. But still, if the boy wants to rethink about this arrangement and commitment, the damage is relatively less in comparison to hastily getting into this relationship. So, spiritual master asks us, are you sure? And if we say yes, Gurudev, yes, I am sure, I am interested, I am committed. Not just because we want a title, Das or Dasi. Because we are interested in taking our Krishna consciousness relationship to the next level, I am sure. So the second time our Shraddha is very clearly tested by our spiritual master. And we have seen this time and again in Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita, Narada Muni tested Dhruva Maharaj, Krishna tested Arjuna, and Parikshit Maharaj was tested by Sukadeva Goswami. Parikshit Maharaj, after Sukadeva Goswami finished describing about the hellish planets, Srila Prabhupada writes about this in the first sloka of Nectar of Instruction purport. Parikshit Maharaj is asking question to Sukadeva Goswami, my dear Gurudev, I just heard about all the hellish planets description from you, but for some reason it doesn't make any sense. How is it that just by doing atonement in the hellish planet will safeguard a person from committing the mistake again? And Sukadeva Goswami said, I agree with you, it will not. I was actually testing your attention and commitment and sincerity in this class. Are you sure if you are, you know, with me? Narada Muni asked the same question to Dhruva Maharaj, are you sure you are committed? And Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj had to prove his commitment to Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. So in the scripture we have plenty of examples where the spiritual master evaluates and checks our commitment. And if we say at that point in time to the spiritual master, yes, Gurudev, I am sure, then what comes after that is, number one, service. Number two, chastisement. Number three, more relationship and interactions and involvement in the family of Gaudiya Vaishnavas. And all three of them are meant to crush our further quotients of ego left within us. When Krishna was told by Arjuna about his desire to surrender, Krishna first evaluated and chastised him. The very first instruction Krishna said to him, Arjuna, was Kata suna kata sumscha nanu choshandi pandita. You are speaking like a learned man, but actually you are talking stupid. So the chastisement is the first natural outcome when the relationship between the spiritual master and the disciple is established, because on that day of initiation, we are letting the spiritual master know that my both the ears are available for you to tweak, to drag me to Krishna's lotus feet. So yes, I am sure. And if you let him do that, he will do that. And he has been doing that, and that's one of the reasons why we are sitting in this forum. And as a part of that, what happens? It crushes the ego within, supposed to be crushing the ego within us. The way it is done is by giving more loving service of Krishna. It goes on and on and on. The relationship becomes stronger and stronger to an extent that what was request to do service from a spiritual master to disciple will become demand to from the spiritual master to disciple, that you have to do it, and will eventually become a lifestyle. From request to demand to lifestyle, the spiritual master transforms, and he keep on asking at every point in time, are you sure? And our Shraddha is tested for the second time. And the way spiritual master does it is it by engaging us in the loving service of the Supreme Lord. So if any one of us, as a part of our daily routine, we are getting more service opportunities, it's an acknowledgement from the Supreme Lord that he heard our chanting, he acknowledges our chanting, because in our chanting we have been requesting Krishna to engage us in his service, and hence he just reciprocating for that. The more intense we are, please expect more and more service opportunity. And the way the service opportunity at times it is going to come is, it won't be any more a request, it will be a demand from the spiritual master. Because we are no more a guest. We are no more a relative. We are no more some third party. We are part of the family. So like how we treat our family with more liberty. The spiritual master takes full liberty upon us and try to demand, you have to do this. And the third thing is, as a part of service, as well as chastisement of the spiritual master, we also get an acknowledgement by the Supreme Lord when devotees, Vaishnavas, visit your houses. Shuddha Bhakata Charana Renu Bhajana Anukula. So it is an acknowledgement when we get service opportunity as well as devotees visiting our houses. In other words, we should yearn to invite devotees to our houses, feed them, serve them, glorify them, engage them in service, hear from them. Not only the senior most in organization ladder, it is also advanced devotees, apparently even though you are a congregation member. Not just advanced devotees, any devotee who is chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Not only just any devotee who is chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, anyone who is interested in chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we need to receive them to our house and engage them or serve them either way. So that way, our service, Vaishnava's visit, as well as the chastisement from request to demand to lifestyle, in that time, our Shraddha gets tested for the second time. And when we keep doing this, at a point in time where we reach the spiritual abode, we are getting qualified to reach the spiritual abode, or we may not fully, you know, reach there, we are just almost got completely purified. The third time, somebody will ask, are you sure? And this time it will be Krishna. Are you sure that you are prepared to now take the leap to come to the spiritual world? At that time also our Shraddha is tested. We have two good examples. Narada Muni, when he was the son of the Shudrani, got opportunity to associate with Paramahamsas, honored their remnants and smeared their dust on his, you know, forehead, got to hear from them and got so much of blessings to an extent that he got self-realized and got to see Paramatma. Narada Muni was so much absorbed in the thoughts of Paramatma, suddenly Paramatma vanished from his thoughts. When Paramatma vanished from his thoughts, Narada Muni started to lament and cry. At that time, Krishna spoke as a sound vibration. He said that, my dear boy, I am very much pleased with your devotion. And what you got is just an acknowledgement for your devotion. You please continue with a similar thought process. Maintain the consciousness for the rest of your life and make sure you want me. So Krishna indirectly said, if you are sure, are you sure? The next life will come to me. As Narada Muni, you will get a privilege to. So this scenario of questioning, are you sure, happens by multiple agencies. In case of Bharat Maharaj, his Shraddha was tested. Of course, he had assumed the very tough service of putting himself through fall down. And he got trapped by whatever little distraction towards the deer, and he had to undergo the transformation. So there are cases where even after the stage of, Bhanu Maharaj once mentioned, even if somebody is at the stage of bhava, bhava is a stage just like a, you know, early morning sunrise. It is neither dark nor the day. So I am completely purified of all the darkness. It is early morning time. I am in the stage of bhava, almost there. Still, there is a chance of getting flipped. So are you sure? Krishna asked then as well. So the theory of are you sure is that if you don't ask yourself, are you sure, if I am completely purified of material desires, either Maya will ask or Guru will ask, leave aside Krishna because that stage is far away. So it is better that we as practicing devotees learn to ask this question, are you sure? Is this the life we want to lead? Are you sure? Is this what we think as happiness? In spite of knowing so many things. And this question should taunt us. And when it taunts us, we need a support system to help us getting rid of that taunt. And that support system is the transcendental loving service of Krishna. So we all are expected to hear the sound from within or without, because Krishna is making necessary arrangements for someone to ask you this question, fearing that what if we ourselves don't ask that question. For those who ask themselves that are you sure, then that's good enough. That's called honest guided introspection. This is our first reflection where we need to learn to question ourselves. If a person gives up all material desires, how long we are going to go on like this? Bhaktivinoda Thakur is singing in the song, Jeev Jago, Jeev Jago. He's saying, Enechi Aushadi Maya Nasi Bara Lagi Hari Nama Maha Mantra Lao Tovi Magi. We have this Aushada, we have this medicine that will wipe out the disease of illusion from which we are suffering. Kota Nidra Javo Maya Pisha Chirakole. Hence, you have the medicine, please get up from the lap of which Maya and get rid of the lethargy. So, the second reflection hence is some set of learning after our introspective question that we ask. We have six set of learnings which will help us transform from are you sure mentality in terms of being questioning and contemplative to being engaged in loving service of Krishna. And the same question we will ask, are you sure is it good enough or should I do more? So as a part of our devotional journey, because what we think today at this point in time in our devotional thought process, what we think at this point in time as devotional progress that we have made is highly superficial, because
When we make the necessary progress, our thoughts, our feelings, our actions, our priorities will all be different. So to help us execute the transcendental loving service properly, let us learn to express ourselves properly. Let us learn whom to express ourselves properly. Let us learn to exclude ourselves from certain things properly. Let us learn to respond to situations properly. Let us learn to prioritize, and eventually let us learn to recognize. What does learn to express actually mean? Because now we have been asking question, are you sure to handle about our material desires? And we have been given an understanding that transcendental loving service of Krishna is the only ways and means by which we can get rid of this material desires, because Krishna Surya Saman Maya Hara Antaka. So we need to progress in transcendental loving service of Krishna, for which we need to learn to express, which means our prayers, our desires, and our request towards the Lord and Vaishnavas need to be refined. Today also we express our need. So we need to learn to express ourselves. That is why the prayers of acharyas, prayers of sadhakas, prayers of madhyama, they are all different. If you see every prayer of an acharya, may it be Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Narottam Das Thakur, Basu Ghosh, Vasudeva Ghosh, you look at everybody's prayer, so refined. There is no tinge of material touch. So the first thing that we need to learn to engage ourselves in transcendental loving service is to learn to express. We have plenty of examples in the Shastra where the person, because of not knowing how to express, of course there's a Leela part connected to that, but not knowing how to express is also a problem. And this learn to express will come from the previous reflection of are you sure. If somebody has been really introspective and questioning ourselves, we will be able to express ourselves nicely. That is why Bhagavad Gita 4.34 very clearly says, Pari Prashnena Sevaya. Not only learn what to express, we also learn how to express. Pari Prashnena Sevaya. Asking the spiritual master that question by which we can make progress. When Srila Prabhupada, when he met first time Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj, he was very strongly influenced by the freedom movement of India. But Srila Prabhupada was, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada was not giving any importance and kind of ignored their ideology and convinced Srila Prabhupada at the first instance. He said that all your thoughts about this freedom movement are highly superficial, highly body conscious, and has nothing to do with spirituality. And that is not eternal, that is highly temporary. So he made, Srila Prabhupada realized in the very first instance what to express properly, and he made Srila Prabhupada's priorities clear in the very first meeting. So we all need to learn that to express the Supreme Lord, express to a spiritual master about our needs to progress in Krishna consciousness. Ye yata mam prapadyante tams tataiva bhajamyaham.
Krishna tells Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita that as somebody surrenders unto me, I reciprocate to that person accordingly. So Krishna, he says, Mama Vartamanu Vartante Manushya Partha Sarvasaha. All of them, as they surrender unto me, I reward accordingly. So if you know to express Krishna very particularly, Krishna knows where is our punctuation and where is our insistence, where we have bold letters, where we put italics in our prayers. Nadanam, najanam, nasundarim, kavitam, va, jagadishakamaye. We may chant this verse, but if somebody is asked to repeat the English translation of it consciously, and that too after gaining lot of Shraddha, that Krishna hears our prayers, will we be able to chant with the same conviction? My dear Lord, I do not want wealth. I do not want followers. I do not want glorifications. I do not want, you know, support, whatever. Girls. So whenever we say, I do not want money, we may feel little, you know, wobbly. Because internally, we have a slightest fear. What if Krishna says, Tata astu, so be it. So there's a fear. So let us learn to express. What to express and how to express, very important. That is why prayers are taught along with the meaning, so that mechanically we start doing it. In Tamil, one of the acharyas in Sri Vaishnava Alvar, he mentioned that Poyen, poyen, endru solli meyen agi vandene. I've been telling a lie. I've been telling a lie to everybody that I am a devotee. I was just trying to, you know, cover up. But one fine day, I found myself devotee by the mercy of so many wonderful Vaishnavas. So sometimes if we know to express ourselves, if we have that eagerness to express, probably the result is much faster available. And as a part of expressing, we should also know whom to express. Many a times, in fact, it was a recent reflection that I was, you know, reflecting about a particular point where nowadays devotees are so much eager and enthusiastic in taking association over social media from very, very far distant people. I am sitting in India, you know, taking association from somebody in United States and somebody from, you know, Australia, somebody from Singapore. I mean, discussing with them a lot of philosophical things, asking questions and convincing ourselves internally that yes, I am actively in Vaishnava association, but in the reality, am I actually engaging in a service in a practical manner or just I'm intellectually discussing? The point I want to say is, learn whom to express is a very important part. If you just intellectually express to some far distant devotee who does not understand or does not have a visibility of our ground reality in the yatra that we are in. So the message that Srila Prabhupada communicates is, every one of the congregation devotee members need to learn to express their full-fledged commitment and service to the local yatra in addition to all their aspirations for association. There are so many letters. Srila Prabhupada insists that the devotees living near the temple, around the temple, in the community of devotees should commit themselves. By that way, our thoughts will translate in action and service opportunities are more and more facilitated to that person in which his material desires are crushed. So sometimes it is also a superficial to just be satisfying, saying that I'm in India, I'm discussing with so-and-so Prabhu in US, so-and-so Mataji in Dubai, so-and-so Maharaj in Singapore, so-and-so person in Malaysia. And what are you doing for your local yatra? No, no, Prabhuji, I'm not getting along with anybody. I'm sitting at home. We are not getting along with anybody. It's just not anybody else's problem. It is also our problem, because it is not that we are fine and perfect. Only the other person is bad. So we need to somewhere or the other learn to get down to the next level of execution and try to challenge us, challenge our consciousness. Am I hiding something off in the garb of being a serious devotee? So hence, let us learn whom to express. If you learn to express to a bona fide spiritual master, if you learn to express to a Vaishnava, if you learn to express a personality who understands your dynamics, who understands your near and dear situation, then he can help you in practical application of Krishna consciousness, through which our material desires will get extinguished. And I learned to express, and I did learn from whom I am supposed to express my heart and seek services. The third is to learn to exclude ourselves from being the beneficiary. Because whenever we express what I want. But as we move progress in Krishna consciousness, we need to express in spite of me what I can do for Krishna. Because this whole episode, this chapter, this sloka, giving up material desires means self-centered thought process. If in my expression of interest, if my desire to progress in Krishna consciousness does not exclude my personal choices, does not exclude me being the beneficiary, then we are still in Mishra Bhakti, some adulterated devotion. So hence the third thing that we need to learn is how to exclude ourselves when we are expressing ourselves to a bona fide authorities, because of which we can get engaged in the transcendental loving service of the Lord completely, as enjoined in revealed scriptures. So now I know to express, what to express and whom to express. I also know to exclude myself. And now, if I can learn to prioritize, because I'm excluding myself, let's prioritize our life in a direction where Krishna is the focus, as we discussed in our last Chaitanya Charitamrita class, previous week, how to be a missionary. So the priority point is about understanding Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam is our life and goal, and in every breath of our life, we need to constantly meditate on how to prioritize my activities in such a way. Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. When you are thinking, walking, talking, sleeping, eating, whatever we do, we try to prioritize in such a manner that Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam becomes our life air. So, learning to prioritize. Now comes the last 2 points, which is when we learn to prioritize, Krishna starts to reciprocate. When we start to orient our life in such a manner, that Krishna will start to, reciprocate to our prayers, what we expressed. Krishna will ask this question, are you sure question now? Through the spiritual master. And sometimes through challenges. Sometimes through pains. Sometimes through difficulties, sometimes through failures in our spiritual endeavor. So let us learn to respond. Krishna may not necessarily come and express himself just as soon as he started praying. It's definitely a good fortune if somebody gets that choice. But Krishna will evaluate if we are sure in this path, so when we are prioritizing our activities, and when Krishna starts to acknowledge our priorities, let's learn to respond him. And how do we respond him if we do not recognize him correctly? So this recognize and respond are the last two things. So let us learn to recognize which is Krishna and which is Maya. Sometimes Prabhupada was, you know, warning devotees. Sometimes devotees doesn't even know Maya is right within your heart, within your temple, within your ashram, if you are not conscious, if you are serious. So hence, the way Krishna wants to transform us, he may be transforming us through some tougher devotees. He may be transforming us through some tougher community members. Maybe transforming us through a tougher family member. So once you surrender to Krishna, expressed yourself from a core of our heart, Krishna, I am yours, and told Krishna that I am ready to serve you, and for that, anything. And Krishna will take it seriously and will make sure we surrender. So hence, let us learn to recognize him and respond him in a very manner. Because if you do not recognize Krishna when he is coming and knocking on your door, we may consider weed as a seed, seed as a weed, as Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami explains. In the bhakti process, there are a lot of anarthas, but there is some anartha which look exactly like Bhakti Lata Bhij. And Krishnadas Kaviraja Goswami says, only by able guidance, we will be able to uproot the real weed and water the real seed. As practicing devotees, especially in this very well-established Krishna consciousness movement, we expect only happy, rosy path. The pain that Srila Prabhupada's disciples, the pain our acharyas, the pain our Goswamis have taken to establish, to show the real process of Krishna consciousness is available to us very easily. You are all reading Leelamrita every Friday. And if you read Leelamrita, you will know what it means, the earlier days of Krishna consciousness. Today, whatever we are getting is like a heavenly treatment. I mean, very well established temple, fantastic prasadam, so many nice technologies available to associate and hear and interact. In terms of resources, we have plenty, but still we are not making necessary progress. So the point is, if we do not know to recognize and we do not know to respond, probably, you know, we will miss a very, very interesting opportunity. So hence the last learning is, learn to recognize and respond it. As I mentioned in the last class, let us not try for spiritual surrogacy. Outsource the pain to all the devotees and let them undergo all the pain, and we just expect the final result pleasure to be made available to us. That is not possible. Each and every one of us need to go through the process of purification and finally get rid of all the upadhis. And then only we will be able to make necessary progress, as explained in this particular shloka of engaging ourselves in the transcendental loving service of Krishna. Tyaktva turna masesha mandalapati shrenim sada tuchavat. Goswamis, they have given up all the designations, including their tridanda, including their janayu. They just wore some loincloths, and all they were doing is going everywhere to help us take up Krishna consciousness. It was not for their requirement they did it. It was only to help us. Hence, let us learn to recognize. If we did not hear Sanatana Goswami's pastime, if we did not hear Billomangala Thakura's pastime, if somebody had come and told you, I went to Vrindavan, I saw a matted hair, loin cloth, dirty, you know, physically appearing dirty person sitting underneath a tree offering dry chapatis to Krishna. From our normal naked eyes, we will not be able to recognize him as Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami told Madan Mohan, I am a sadhu, I will only give you chapati without salt or without any sabji. If you want to stay here, this is all you will get. And Madan Mohan chose to stay with Sanatana Goswami and ready to eat whilst he wished to eat chappan bhog. He chose to eat because he wanted to stay with Sanatana Goswami. So if we do not learn to recognize from the eyes of Shastra, the eyes of the sadhus, and through our ears hearing from them, we do not know how to respond. Probably Krishna would have come and gone, we would be still searching for him. Hence, let us learn to respond. And for that, this devotional service is important. To such a person, this debts towards demigods, sages and forefathers are immaterial because Krishna takes charge of that person. Unfortunately, what happens? We pick up those things which Krishna says you don't need to do it, but we fail to note a precondition that is attached to not doing this. When Arjuna asked the question to Krishna in Bhagavad Gita, that my dear Lord, because you said I am giving up so much of my so-called activities and trying to follow your advice, but what if I am not able to completely follow? I would have neither done this nor done that. That's when Krishna is saying this verse, Kshipram bhavati dharmatma sasvak chantim digachati. Kaunteya pratijanehi name bhakta pranashati. So in that verse, Krishna is very nicely explaining that how that my devotee, if he has taken Krishna consciousness seriously, even though he may be little lax, I take responsibility and he will never need to take birth again. But Krishna warns Arjuna, this is not a free pass just because you are a devotee, you can do whatever you want. If you are a hypocrite, if you are a person who did not take Krishna consciousness seriously, neither you did your material responsibility seriously, I will not take responsibility. Apichetu jura duracharo bhajate mam ananya bhak. Even if one commits most abominable action, I am ready to help that person. But if he only does abominable action and not taking up Krishna consciousness seriously, then I can't help. So the personalities who are self-realized, who have shown utmost sincerity and seriousness in practicing Krishna consciousness for the pleasure of the Lord without any personal interest, will never need to be serving demigods, sages, forefathers and so many other people separately, because they are already taking care of the root and watering them. All the other trees and twigs and branches and leaves and other trunks will get nourished. So before we conclude, I just want to summarize our discussion today. As a part of our discussion, we discussed how it is extremely important for us to make necessary progress in Krishna consciousness, as Mahaprabhu has been encouraging Sanatana Goswami through the process of devotional service. And we discussed about two sets of reflection.
The first set of reflection is about the theory of Are You Sure? In which a person is questioned by Maya through mind, intelligent friends, relatives, neighbors, family members, society at large, to test his Shraddha. Then when he keeps practicing and wins over this challenge of so many people's question on Are You Sure? The spiritual master questions and checks our Shraddha, crushes our ego, engages in service, enables us to get more and more devotees' associations. So we discuss that how a devotee's visit to your house is a blessing and an acknowledgement of the Supreme Lord. So do getting more and more service opportunities. And once we keep doing this and making progress, finally before Krishna accepting us, he would also ask us and expect us to demonstrate the commitment completely without any personal motive. So Krishna is also going to ask, Are you sure? Question. So to help us give up all the material desires, let us learn to question ourselves before Maya questions us, before even spiritual master questions us, before Krishna questions us, let us question ourselves if I have given up all material desires. The answer will be negative till we are completely engaged in transcendental loving service of Krishna. So as a part of that, we discussed our second reflection, which is we need to learn to express, what to express and how to express, as described in the verse 4.34 Bhagavad Gita. And we also need to know to whom to express. And while expressing, we should learn to know how to exclude ourselves being the beneficiary and prioritize, learn to prioritize our life in such a manner that Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam is our only mission. And when we do this, Krishna will reciprocate. And when Krishna reciprocates, let us learn to recognize Krishna, because Krishna initially may not come in the form that we expect. He will come in the form that he wants to give mercy to us for our transformation. And then when we learn to recognize him and learn to respond him properly, we will be freed from all the debts to so many people, and we all need to do is just glorify the Supreme Lord for the rest of the life, so that we can eventually go back home, back to Godhead. Thank you so much. Shri Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. If there are any questions or comments, we can discuss.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, Vandavat Pranams. Thank you so much. Very nice talk. Especially when you were talking about the theory of asking, Are you sure? That was very, very nice. And about how sincere and serious we must be in each and every step. That was quite a revelation. Thank you so much, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Any other questions or comments?
Hare Krishna, Ji, Prabhuji, Koti Koti Dandavat Pranam to your Seva. We are so fallen soul that your lecture is so touched to heart, Prabhuji, but we are not that much sincere. We have to hear 1, 2, 3 times, then we understand. And it's really touched to heart that today you just inspiring us. Are you sure what we are taking vows? In initiation time, it's Prabhuji, we have to do our seva so sincerely, especially japa and reading Shishi Bhagavatam, Shishi Chanachanamut, and hearing, not only hearing, but whatever we hear, we have to try to share with the Vaishnava. And Prabhuji, second realization is touched to heart that before Krishna express what express I cannot express very nicely, but priority to Sri Krishna Prabhuji. And you are given one more example of Sanatan Goswami, that Shishi Atta Madan Mohan has a Chappan Boga in his plate, but he is ready to go with Shishi Goswami, Sanatan Goswami. That Sanatan Goswami said that I am not given even thought to you. So that how much struggle of Six Goswami, our Acharya Srila Prabhupada is doing to give us Krishna consciousness, and how the poorest Vinjan we, how the poorest duty we are, what we are doing for them. Every Friday, because of Priti Vilashini Gopi, we read Shishi Bhagavad, Shishi Prabhupada Amruta, then we understand Prabhuji how much hard time Srila Prabhupada disciples, Srila Prabhupada, our Acharya Goswami passed. Thank you very much for today's realization, everyday realization. Thank you very much for your wonderful association. Hare Bol, Hare Krishna.
Thank you. All Guru Srila Prabhupada. Any other comments or questions?
Hare Krishna Prabhu, All Guru Srila Prabhupada and Guru Maharaj. I have a question, and I think you kind of answered it, but I just wanted to get my clarification. One thing, I went a couple of thoughts before my question. I really liked your analogy about the train, that humility, you said two tracks, humility and
gratitude.
Gratitude, yes, yes. I really liked that analogy of what we needed to move our devotion towards our destination. And also I was thinking when you said that take others along, I was thinking, as you said that, I was thinking that even in our gratitude and our humility, we can also take our forefathers if we can get to that stage. So I was just thinking about that. That was a really nice analogy. My question is, and I, like I said, I think you kind of answered it. So when it comes to doing these duties, these prescribed samskaras, as we call, you know, like the sadhana ceremony and all these, many times people say, oh, you don't have to do any of those things because you're practicing Krishna consciousness. But I'm understanding from what you say is that we're not at that point where we're pure devotees yet. So we should continue these, but with the right mindset. Is that right? Okay.
That's right, because Gopala Bhatta Goswami, in his Hari Bhakti Vilas, he is explaining how all the oblations and obligations can as well be done in a Vaishnava way. What is happening in the general Smartha Vidhi or general outside practices is more towards self-centered prarthana and self-centered oblations. Even if I'm giving oblation, we just, even in the prayer or in the request that we make in the oblation, to see that what can I get. I mean, typical, if you go to any South Indian wedding or South Indian, or in, not even South Indian, typically any Shastric programs which are not directly driven by Vaishnavites, there are a lot of Ashirvada mantra. They say it's a mantra that is to bless the couple. And the mantra goes like this: Dhanyam, Dhanam, Pasum, Bahubutra, Labam, Sadasam, Vatsaram, Dirgamayuhu. So the whole prarthana, if you actually translate it, it says that you are blessed with Dhanyam, you know, grains, Dhanam, wealth. Pasum means all the, you know, you have cow, you have all the animals that are needed in your house. Labam, success. So in the prarthana, there is nowhere there is devotion. So when once one Brahmana visited Mahaprabhu's house, he gave similar blessings to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then Mahaprabhu started crying and saying that if at all I made a mistake, please excuse me. Don't, punish me like this. This Brahmana was confused. Why are you crying? I am giving you blessings. He says, don't give such a blessing. If I get all these things, I will not remember about Krishna. Please give me blessings so that we are constantly remembering Krishna. That is why always Jayapatak Maharaj, whenever he, touches his hand on somebody, that he says, Krishne Mati Rastu, which means may you always remember Krishna. So the point is, even when we offer oblations, we are definitely not supposed to evade our samskara dharma till we are sure that we are sacrificing or ignoring or we are foregoing one and only for the pleasure of higher purposes and not for some personal evading. And then also we are expected to follow the oblations as recommended by Vaishnava Acharyas, so that the intention for which the oblation is to be done is done in that intention and not add more to our kitty of punya. We don't need punya, we only need bhakti. From that perspective, yes, we need to do these oblations in the light of the recommendations and directives given by Vaishnava Acharyas. Make sense?
Yes, Prabhu, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna. Okay, any other thoughts and comments from others? Okay, thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity to be in your Sangha. Looking forward for more. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Dandavat Pranam. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Prabhuji. Thank you for the very perfect answer and very nice conversations between devotees.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Very nice. Hare Krishna.
We can end the call. Vancha Kalpata Rubhishtha.
Patitanam
Pavnebhyo. Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Ananta Koti Vaishnavaranda Ki Jai. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Sri Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Ki Jai. His Grace Ram Giridhari Prabhu Ki
Jai. Thank you, Prabhuji. Ji Ram Giridhari Prabhu Koti Koti Dandavat Pranam.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna Hare Hare.